This is my first video and I'm going to give you an insight about a coding platform called code.org where beginners like you and me can run the code on a web browser like Chrome, Mozilla or Internet Explorer you need not even install a software on your PC or laptop. So you need to create an account first. So if you have an account, you can directly sign in, but if you don't, you need to sign up and create an account. So create an account. I'm continuing with Google. So my age is 14, so I'll add that. Gender male. And you need to put the account type as well, so it is required. So I am a student, so account type is student. And then create it. So the project is now in block mode. So on the top right corner, there's a show text mode. So please click on that and then you can use your keyboard and type. So function draw is a function wherein you need to write all the functions of the variable of the object that you create. Suppose assigning velocity or speed to your object, making it move. All that has to be written in the function draw. I'll name the project, so I'll save it now, and this is the output screen on the left. The output screen is totally 400,400, so it's 400 by 400. The maximum x value, that is the horizontal position, is 400, and the maximum y value, that is the vertical position, is 400. So I'll create a variable. So the code to create a variable is var and my name is Aditya, so I'll name it Aditya, var Aditya. And you need to write the code equals to create sprite followed by round brackets to create that sprite. So in round brackets you have to mention the x value, the y value, width and the height. So x value, I want it in the center. So in the center of canvas with size 400 by 400 will be 200,200, right? So x value is 200, y value is 200. I'll show you the grid view. So 200 200, and I'll keep the width as maybe 50 and the height 10. So in the function draw, you need to mention in the on the last line of function draw before the ending curly bracket, the line before the ending curly bracket, you need to mention draw sprites followed by round brackets to draw that sprite. It has to be drawn. So here in the middle we have a rectangular object, and you can go to the animation tab to create an animation. So I'll search for a hero. I'll pick up a hero image, but I don't get that. So I'll search for a appropriate image. Maybe we can do the animation part later. We can do the coding. I'll teach you one more concept. So I'll show you how to change the background color. So you need to write the code backgroundd, background followed by round brackets, and mention the color in double inverted commas. So I'll show you, if you don't put it in double inverted comma, what happens. So if I run the code now, it will show me an error in the debug console. So and one more important thing, you need to have a semicolon on the end, in the end of each line. Like after var Aditya equals to create sprite, and at the end of the round bracket and the closing round bracket, I have put a semicolon. The same way in the second line also I have done that, and I've put the color blue in double inverted commas, so the background color has changed. I'll change it to black. See, it's black now. So I can search for images. The background image color and the background color and the image color has to be the same. Like if the background color is black, the image color also has to be black. So I go to and my background color is black, so I'll go to tools and search for the black, search for a black image with a black background. So I actually don't get that, so I'll change the background color of my output screen. I'll make it white. And now I'll maybe save the second image. I'll save it on my desktop. Save. Then go to code.org, add a new animation, upload image, go to desktop, search for the image, open it, and then see, you have to add an animation to your object, you need to write a code. So after the line where you declare your variable, you can set your animation. So the variable name is Aditya, so aditya.setAnimation followed by the round brackets. And inside the round brackets, you have to type the link. So code.org, if you have uploaded the image, the link will come directly. So see, download.jpg_1 has come. That too in double inverted commas. See, now the image has come. So we'll continue with code.org in the next video as well. I'll teach you more concepts. Thank you very much. If you haven't subscribed yet, please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Thank you again.